fucking mic so high, shit. It's taller than me. A little bit about myself. I migrated here from Kansas City, Missouri. Yeah, long way away from home. Portland has changed me a lot in many ways that I didn't even notice until I went back home to Kansas City, Missouri. You guys got a lot of weird shit here, you won't get beat down by a cops for smoking weed on the corner. Bacon donuts. You can make it outside as long as you don't have a boner. But let's be honest, it's Portland. That's a little bit hard for some people, so. But yeah, I didn't notice it until I went back home. I went out with some of my friends. I'm like, hey man, I'm trying a gluten-free diet. He looked at me, he's like, nigga, what the fuck is gluten? I looked back at him, I'm like, you don't know what gluten is? Are you fucking retarded? Turn around to my other friend, I'm like, this nigga don't know what gluten is. He looked back at me like, nigga, what the fuck is gluten? That's just one of the many ways. I have these little shorts. My dad hadn't seen me in a while. They cut off right at the balls. I like to show off sometimes. My dad comes in the house. I got these little shorts on. Eat some ice cream on the couch. He's like, what the fuck are you wearing? He hit me with a, what are those? Like, dad, I'm not gay, man. I'm kind of questioning that now. I don't know though. Portland is very weird. I like it though. Now that I smoke a lot more weed, I catch myself thinking about a lot of dumb shit. Like the other day I went out to eat. I was just like, girls did so much shit for you. Like, what if balls were just as attractive as tits? You go to McDonald's, you'd be like, that would be $10.50. Like, will it be $10.50? I don't know. I just think that would work out for guys and get a lot more free shit. The world would get a lot more. Women are fighting for equal rights. I want my balls to be just as attractive. Let's see who else. Turning 25, I grew up in the 90s. I got to see some of the best hip hop around, but this fucking 2010 shit is making me rethink hip hop. Like, I don't know if I can listen to Wayne anymore. He's going by Tunchi. All he's talking about is eating pussy. It's like, you got 7 kids, man. You need to start with the dad. You got Young Thug. Lifestyle. And then this nigga comes out in a dress. Like, I don't know if I'm going to be about that lifestyle. Will Smith. I don't know if you guys have seen Jaden Smith lately, but that's a weird little motherfucker. I saw an article. He wore a dress to his prom with his girlfriend. He's like, I'm just being myself. I'm like, you listen too much, little or young dog. Maybe little one too. I don't know. What else is wrong with talking about? I hate when people ask to touch my hair. I can understand this Japanese guy was like, whoa, can I touch your hair? I'm like, sure, you probably never touched my guy's hair before. But most people, they just come up and grab the shit. Like, it's a brand new cat or something. You just pet me. I'm like, are you kidding me? These are dreads. I'm not going to wash these for the next 3 months. Whatever you just had on your hands. It's a part of me now. And I am a part of you. I don't know. They were talking about, this guy said he's going to start saying pretzel instead of nigger. And I don't know, it just works out different for me, being from the Midwest. My parents didn't allow us to cuss, but they allowed us to say nigger. So, nigga meant every cuss word under the gun.
Just like motherfucker.
Just like, what do you mean? I don't know. Nigga, I was somewhere. Don't worry about it. Who is them? Them niggas over there? Nah, nigga. I don't know. I feel like on the spot, I can't show you how much I say, nigga. But if you have a conversation with me, you'd be like, damn, this nigga says nigga a lot. It might be his favorite word. And it is. It is. Because I feel like we get a lot of flack for saying nigga. But it's like, if you can listen to all the country you want, and they'll say honky a million times. But if I call somebody white a honky, I'm racist. Like, really? 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 I don't know. I waited 5 years to go back to school, and it's fucking terrible. I really wish I would've never went back, but now I'm like, damn, dude, you already got student loans, you don't have to pay no matter what. Shit. Fucking hate school. And now that I've been on winter break, all my friends are like, you drink so much. I'm like, dude, that's because I'm in school. I can't be like you getting drunk every fucking Wednesday. I got responsibilities and shit. Trying to better myself, get somewhere. I don't know, a little bit more about myself. I'm a cook, and you know, I'm a pretty good cook, I would say I am. And every time I talk to a new female or something, they're like, oh, you're gonna cook for me. No, I'm fucking not. I cook all day at work, you're gonna cook for me. Like, really? You're not gonna cook for me? I'll suck your dick. I'm pretty sure you're already going to do that, so that's kind of straightforward, but let me be honest, we're the millennials, so you know, we like to keep it ratchet. Like, I'm fucking scared for our generation's kids. That's why I'm like, yeah, mom, don't expect these young kids from me. What are you really going to say is your kids, like, how'd your mom meet? Well, you know, your mom had her ass cheeks spread it right in my face, and you know, I just couldn't say no. I just could not say no. I didn't have a condom, and I just went for it. 9 months later, you did. Wow, that's really romantic. I'm in the fifth grade, I already got a kid.
Oh my God.
That's terrible, but that's where we're headed. Let's see. I took a public speaking class to better my stand-up comedy, but all it really did for me was standing in front of people nervous that I've been for 3 months now trying to figure out what the fuck I'm doing with my life. Well, yeah. I'm Ron Webb. Thank you guys for coming out. It was nice seeing all you guys coming out. Have a good night.